Hello my dear students, welcomes all of you in our PPS video lecture series. I am Professor Bhumi Patel from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology, and in our previous lectures already we have completed the theory, that is structure of C program, that is very most IMP theory. When we are creating our C program, we have to follow that structure. So today I am taking examples practically how to write C program in different ways. Today we are continue with two different problem. First, we have to find the area of circle, and second, to convert the temperature from Fahrenheit to Celsius. Let's start how we can write. Here I share my screen with you, and there are so many editors available for writing C program like Notepad++, Dev C++, Turbo C, but here I am using Dev C++. See here the blue color icon, double click on it, then choose the file and new file you have to select. So here you have to write your coding for a program. You all guys knowing the structure of C program, and first section is documentation sections that consist of set of comment lines, and there are two different comment line. First is a single line and second is a multiple line. Let's see how we can write practically. So in double slash you have to write the title of our program, and first program is find the area of circle. So write down to find the area of circle. This is what single line comment. Why double slash and single line is there? But if you want multiple line comment, then how you can write? Instead of double slash, now you have to change slash star. Then after, in a second line also you can write, suppose it is developed by me, so by Bhumi Patel, and then you have to stop by star and slash. So this is nothing but the multiple line comments. You can write any options. Now this documentation section is optional part. This is just regarding our program, the title or a date or a program size, something that. Now second section is a link section, that link with our system library. So for that we have to include our library using has include, then stdio.h. this is what header files, so that the extension is .h, and the full form is full form of stdio is standard input output header files. So all the functions that are available for input and outputs are in a these header files that we have to add in our program. Then after, the third section is a definition sections that defines all the symbolic constant. Here you need any symbolic value. Yes, for finding the area of circle the formula is pi r square, and pi is our symbolic value. So for that we have to use the line, that is has define, and then the variable pi and value, that is 3.14. so here our definition section is completed. Now fourth is a global declaration sections. Here no need of this section, so skip it and then jump onto the next section, that is a main function sections. For that we have to write void main. In a void mains always there are two brackets opening and closing that indicates our start and stop. In these two brackets we have to write declaration part and executable part, and declaration part is just like this float, then input variable is suppose radius, that is r, and output variable is area. So here I am writing the variable area. So this is known as declaration part. Here we are declaring two variables, r for input, that is our radius, and area as an our output. After declaration we have to write executable part, and this is our logic. So the logic is nothing but our formula, and that is area equals pi into r into r. Now we have to print that answer, and for that we have to use printf functions. In a printf, write down area of circle equals percentage f. Now what is the meaning of percentage f first? So it is a control strings. According to the data types, you have to choose. If your data type is in a real value, that is float value, then you have to write percentage f. If your input or output is in an integer form, means the whole number without decimal points, then you have to choose for an integer percentage d. This theory we have to learn in a details in our next lectures. So right now you have to remember, for a float percentage f we have to write, and then after you have to use comma and the variable, that is area. Now if you remember, the all the statements in a declaration part and executable parts must be end with a semicolon. So here each and every statements must be end with semicolon. So here our program is completed. Now the value of r is what? So here I am assigning r equals, suppose, 3. So our radius is 3, and according to the radius the area is generated. So execute this program. For execution you have to choose, for a compilation, F9, and for executing this program F10, shortcut key. Also you can choose from a menu bar, execute and then compile. So what is the meaning of compilations? It checks any errors or not. So here the error is 00, that is indicated, but before that we have to save your program, and for that you have to write here the name of program, suppose that is 1, our first practical. So I am giving 1.c, and .c is nothing but the extension for our C files, and save it. Now again execute and compile this. There is no any error, so you can run this program using F10. Here the black screen is nothing but our output screen, we can say it is our console. Here you can see the answer, area of circle equals 28.26000. So according to the input 3, the output is generated, but it becomes fixed value. Every times when you are running this program, the same output is generated, but it is meaningless, because according to input it is generated. Means if user enter 10, then output is generated different. If enter 12, then again the output is different. For that what we have to do? Here we have to assign value no. This is known as a compilation, compile time initialization, means our fixed value. Instead of that fixed value, now we have to use another method that called runtime initialization of variables. How it is? For that we have to use first the printf, and in printf we have to write enter radius and then end with a semicolon. After that the input function is scanf, that takes the data from the user. In a scanf we have to write percentage f again, that is nothing but the control string for a float data type, and the variable name, that is r, and end with a semicolon. So this is nothing but the runtime initialization. Now user enter the input, execute the same program again, compile it first, no error, then run this program. Here the message is enter radius, and now you have to enter some value. Suppose I am entering 5, then the area of circle is generated. So this method we have to use in our each and every program, that is runtime initialization, user enter input value. Now for better understandings, let's take another example for converting temperature from Fahrenheit to Celsius. How we can change in a same program? First we have to change the title, that is what? To convert temperature from Fahrenheit to Celsius. So here, any need of pi variable? No, because the formula for finding temperature in Celsius is C equals F minus 32 divided by 1.8. You all are knowing that formula. So no need of pi, so remove that. Now the two variables are needed. First is a Fahrenheit value and second is a Celsius value. So our input is in a Fahrenheit, so take variable F, and output in a Celsius, so take the variable C. Here we have to change, enter now temperature in Fahrenheit, and according to Fahrenheit again the variable is changed. Now instead of R we have to put F variables, that is our input. Now change the formula for finding temperature in Celsius, that is C equals in bracket F minus 32 divided by 1.8, and change here again in a printf. The answer is in a C, and what it is? It is nothing but the temperature in Celsius. Now save this program first and then execute it, compile. So there is no any errors, so you can run this program. Here you can see the message, enter temperature in F, and suppose I am entering 100 temperatures, then temperature in Celsius will be 37.7779. So here we are completing two program, area of circle and second is a temperature from Fahrenheit to Celsius. I hope you guys now understand well the structure of C program practically. And if you have any query, then contact me anytime. If you like this video, then thumbs up. If you think this video will help some of your friends, then do share this video with them. Also, you can subscribe my channel, so when I upload new video, you get a notifications.